Iran's state media says that the country's supreme leader has pardoned tens of thousands of detained people, among them participants of anti-government protests. But human rights groups are voicing scepticism about the decree. Ayatollah Ali Khamenei made the announcement on the anniversary of the 1979 Islamic Revolution. But the pardon excludes people with international ties or anyone facing spying charges. Nearly 20,000 people have been arrested in nationwide protests, which were sparked by the death of a young woman, Jina Mahsa Amini, while in police custody last September. We can get more on this from Yelda Zabash, the head of DW's Persian service. Yelda, can you tell us why people are so sceptical about this announcement?
Yes, of course. Well, there is reason to be sceptical, and we actually should put it in the right context when we talk about this announcement. Of course, as you have mentioned, there is the anniversary, the 44th anniversary, actually, of the Islamic Republic ahead, and this is very common that the Supreme Leader, Ayatollah Khamenei, pardons prisoners. In this case, though, talking about ten thousands of prisoners is misleading, because we're not actually talking about those who have been imprisoned during the last 5 months ongoing revolution and protests. It is normally prisoners, detainees on maybe crimes like not having paid their bills or robbery. But in this case, he said there might be also people who have take part in the protests. What we have to see here, though, is it's not that they will be pardoned and then they will be released. They will have to really sign, and they have to regret. And in order to get this kind of regret for taking part in protests, which is not a crime at all, they will be tortured. So, and then when they are freed or released, they're signing that whenever they take part again in protests or anything else, they will be confronted with very stricter punishments. So it is basically being released from prison into another prison, which is then maybe at home. So it's not. We really have to be careful. And the other point is actually that I wanted to make is, of course, the prisons are full. So basically, sooner or later, they have to release many of those who are not even, they are not political activists. They're just normal, regular young people, mostly, who have taken part in protests and have raised them not being satisfied with the government and wanting change.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yelda, I wanted to ask you, a recent survey is said to show that more than 80% of the people interviewed oppose the Islamic Republic. What do you make of that poll?
This is a very interesting survey because, you know, it's very, like, credible data on public opinion within Iran is very rare. And this this survey by an independent research foundation, Gamon, in Netherlands, they actually show, and they have asked around 160,000 people within Iran and around 40,000 outside in Iranian diaspora in 130 different countries. But it's very crucial that it's only around 15% of the people who have been asked. So the base of the supporter base of the Iran's regime is only 15%, whereas some years ago they have conducted also surveys, these kind of surveys, and there was 60% against the Islamic Republic. Now it is over 80%, and we have over 80% within Iran saying that they support the ongoing protests, and 70% of them actually are or saying that they believe that this revolution, what they call it, or what they think, say that they feel it to be, will lead to a success.
All right, Yelda Zabash, the head of DW's Persian service, thanks so much for that.
Thank you.